We're heading down into the Coachella Valley now through the San Gorgonio Pass. On the left, we have the San Bernardino Mountains, and on the right, we have the San Jacinto Mountains, which are also considered a transverse range, even though they kind of bank a little bit more to the south as we enter the Coachella Valley. We are only going as far south as the Indio area. That's where the San Andreas splits apart into the Mission Creek and the Banning Strands. From there, we'll pivot, kind of go northwest, follow along the Mission Creek strand, which is considered now to be the more volatile of the two. We'll go through the Desert Hot Springs area, check that area out. This place is called Biskra Palms. There's some palms up there. There's some kind of a quarry or maybe a mine over there. It's all fenced off, no trespassing. Somewhere around here is where the Banning and the Mission Creek strands diverge. This is actually like the south end of where they split apart. These orange lines are a quaternary fault map overlay from the U.S. Geological Survey. So we head northwest away from the intersection. You can see the Banning Strand is pretty wonky and irregular. It was originally thought that was the more dynamic of the two strands, but scientists have recently concluded that the Mission Creek is the more dynamic and fast-moving of the two. In an area called Pushwalla Canyon, scientists have made some precise measurements just a couple of years ago, and they had concluded that the Mission Creek strand's moving at about 21.6 millimeters plus or minus per year. The stream that flowed over the fault here was offset and driven to the northwest along with the Pacific Plate for a time being, and later that kind of dried up and it established a new drainage through a new canyon later on. But anyway, I suppose there's signs of a lot of what they call aseismic movement here, meaning it's independent of earthquakes. Scientists can actually see it on the surface. And they've concluded that between 6 and 9 meters of elastic strain has accumulated along the fault. What's more is that the San Andreas fault system has not had a rupture along the southernmost part of California for nearly 300 years. My understanding is that in the Pushwalla Canyon area, geologists were able to study and measure an exposed part of the Mission Creek fault, whereas as we go northwest, closer to the mountains, we may have more of the alluvial debris, the rocks and the sand, and even roads and buildings on top of things where it gives a calm surface, but deep underneath the ground there is still the slippage rate of 0.9 inches per decade, and the material above it is kind of locked up and that is building up elastic tension. We're heading northwest now toward Desert Hot Springs. Let's go check out the Mission Creek Fault along these hills down here. There's a house right up on top over it. The Banning Strand is moving at about 2.5 millimeters per year. It's also considered very volatile and capable of producing a large quake. Historically, it's long overdue, so it also is capable of producing a quake, maybe within my lifetime. One of these strands, it's a very good chance it's gonna be the epicenter. The issue with the Banning Strand is it's closer to the LA Basin and more densely populated urban centers. The Mission Creek Strand, although it does go right through Desert Hot Springs, it will be buffered because it actually does go up into bedrock mountains.
it will probably be felt in the Los Angeles Basin, but not nearly as strong as a shaker from the Banning Strand. But yeah, it continues on down that way, heading right for Desert Hot Springs, right off there.
We are just now entering the southeast corner of the town of Desert Hot Springs. I thought I would just do a flyover in Google Earth following along the Mission Creek strand of the San Andreas Fault. I'll zoom in a bit. One can see a little bit of how it's shaping the land somewhat. It's not the most obvious of earthquake faults, though. It doesn't make a really clear scar on the landscape. As we go northwest, there's a resort. It goes right through. I did go down and explore this area at ground level. That's the resort on the left. I believe that's Mount San Jacinto in the background.
Somewhere around here, the Mission Creek strand crosses. Goes somewhere to the right of that hill, in between that, what is a hotel or a resort, I'm not sure, but it comes diagonally. It crosses this street somewhere.
There is a high school down the street where I did observe some shifting of the sidewalks. However, there was very little in the way of what one would call a seismic creep, where the ground on the surface is moving along with the movement of the fault. This looks like some kind of a newer condominium complex of some kind. The developer seems to have known not to build across the fault line here. But many of the homes in the main part of Desert Hot Springs were probably built in the 80s, 70s, 80s, 90s perhaps. Long before scientists knew of the dangers of this fault line. Unfortunately, many homes were built right on top of it. And if it proves true that they're 6 to 9 meters of elastic strain, then yeah, these homes would have already been kind of broken apart if there was what they call a seismic creep, where everything's kind of going with the flow of the fault movement. So there, I saw very little in the way of that. And what we're likely to have, though, is that tension building up at a rate of about, I think, about 8.5 inches per decade. So these homes that are 40, 50 years old would have already been split apart by a good meter or more. The juncture of Palm and Buena Vista, the fault line goes kind of corner to corner. It kind of clips this corner on the left. Again, no sign on the surface. Everything's peaceful. But as I continue northwest, we see it crossing more and more commercial and residential buildings. Apologies for the rendering, it's a bit slow. I'm using a very low-end laptop computer for this whole video, and I'm really taxing the RAM and the processing power. But I think we get the idea. This is called a KML file that's available for download from the USGS Geological Survey site. It's a format called Keyhole Markup Language, which is a format developed by Google for just the purpose of overlaying data over Google Earth images. So you're free to download this, and you basically, if you have Google Earth installed on your desktop computer, you basically just kind of pop it open. It defaults to kind of a 1 pixel wide line for the quaternary faults. I had to beef it up to like 12 pixels so we could actually see it. As we go up northwest, there's what looks like a newer subdivision with some pretty nice looking spacious homes, but the developer could not have known just how potentially dangerous it would be to build across this line. And as we continue northwest through a lot of open space, there's kind of an isolated subdivision that's part of Desert Hot Springs in the northwest. It's a posh golf course community with very large mansions. Again, it's fairly new looking as well. It probably built maybe 20 years ago. But again, the developer just built houses smack dab right on top of the fault line. A line that may have 6 to 9 meters of elastic strain on the ground beneath it. That's 18 to 27 feet. That could really disrupt this community here. As we zoom out, it kind of puts it in scale, puts it in perspective, how they built this grid out here in the desert. It's pretty much surrounded by so much open space. It's mostly private land as well. So I think they could have maybe made a better choice for this posh golf course gated community. I'm going up into the northwest corner of Desert Hot Springs now. The Mission Creek Fault comes up to right about this corner of this subdivision over here. Continues along the edge of this foothill right here. It's somewhere up there. But I'm losing my light. I decided to stay the night, one more night, had a little impromptu camping trip out here and enjoyed a beautiful sunrise and some beautiful views of the San Jacinto Mountains. I wanted to take at least a hike into the Mission Creek area before leaving the Coachella Valley. So the Mission Creek Strand continues on up into the mountains, and behind us back toward Indio, where it merges with the Banning Strand and it becomes, I guess, a more unified San Andreas once again. Continues on through the Salton Sea, where I guess it merges up with another complex kind of fault system. Anyway, I'm gonna wrap it up here. It's been a really eye-opening experience. And thank you for watching.